We are continuing the same chapter, that is the foreign exchange rate. Yesterday we did about flexible exchange rate that was determined by the demand for foreign exchange and supply of foreign exchange, that is the two market forces. Yesterday we discussed about the determinants of demand for foreign exchange. So therefore we are continuing the same, that is the determinants of the supply of the foreign exchange. So today we are going to start from that is the determinants of supply. Determinants of supply of foreign exchange. Supply of a foreign exchange means this is the inflow of a foreign exchange. Inflow of a foreign exchange means these are the determinants by which we are able to earn foreign exchange. The foreign exchange means the dollar, they will come to our economy and that will become the supply of foreign exchange. So which are the determinants through which we can earn foreign exchange? Number one is export of goods and services. Exports of goods and services means by selling the goods and services to the rest of the world, to the foreign countries, we can earn foreign exchange and that will become the gain. Second is foreign direct investment, FDI or FII, foreign institutional investment, means the foreign investment in any form, either direct investment or portfolio investment, that is the institutional investment, purchasing of shares or bonds. This will also the source of supply, because when the foreigners, they with the foreign company or MNCs, they will come to India, invest here, they will purchase our factors, automatically the foreign exchange will inflow to our economy. Then direct purchase, this is the direct purchase by foreign tourists. Foreign tourists. Tourists means the foreign tourists, when they come to India, they will spend foreign currency here and that will become the inflow of the foreign exchange. Then loan, or we can say external loan it is called as, or loan from rest of the world. When our government take the loan from any foreign government or any international institutions like IMF or World Bank, when we borrow the loan, then we are able to supply foreign exchange in our economy. Similarly, grants and donations. Grants and donations from the rest of the world. All these are the from the rest of the world. During this COVID-19 pandemic, WHO, that gave the grants and donation to our economy. So when any country gets the grants and donation due to any calamity, due to any normal circumstances, then that grants and donation will also come in the form of foreign exchange, and that is also the supply as well as the inflow of foreign exchange. Then one more, that is called as the remittances. Remittances by NRIs. NRIs. That is the non-resident Indians who are settling abroad. They are sending the money to their friends, to their relatives, to their family members. When this money in the form of foreign exchange comes to India, this is also the supply of foreign exchange. Then factor income. Factor income from abroad. From abroad. Any of the our Indian resident getting the income from any foreign company or from the foreign government. Then for example, Indian resident is working in the Russian embassy, which is situated in India. Russian embassy in India foreign exchange rate and supply of foreign exchange. There is positive relationship. Positive relationship means as the price of foreign exchange increases, supply of foreign exchange also increases, other things remain constant. No change in other factors. Price of foreign exchange means price of dollar. When the price of dollar increases, then the supply of dollar in India also increases. These are the factors which are responsible. For example, dollar is increasing. Earlier dollar was always like this. $1 was equal to ₹16. Now it becomes, for example, 70. This is the increase in foreign exchange rate. When the foreign exchange rate increases, then the supply of foreign exchange rises because exports become cheaper. This is the question of the board. Okay, when the price of the foreign exchange increases, why the supply of a foreign exchange increases in India? Give any three reasons. You can find out all these determinants. When the price of foreign exchange increases, means purchasing power of the dollar in India increases. Therefore, exports become cheaper for them. They can buy same amount of goods or they can buy more goods and services with the same amount of dollar. Similarly, FDI from the foreign investors, they will come to India because investment in India, that will become cheaper. More tourists will come to India because here the direct purchase by them will become cheaper. Well, look, any three points you can explain in this, the reason. When the price increases, supply of the foreign exchange increases. Therefore, supply of the foreign exchange, that is our total scope. Yes. This is all about the supply of the foreign exchange. Now, third system of exchange rate. Now we have discussed the two, the fixed exchange rate system. Second was the flexible exchange rate system, which was determined by the market forces, that is the demand for foreign exchange and supply of foreign exchange. These are the determinants of the demand and supply. Now we are going to shift towards the third, that is managed floating exchange rate. Managed floating exchange rate system. Managed floating exchange rate system. Which is also called as dirty floating. This is also called as dirty floating. So what does it mean? Floating hai. Exchange rate means this is the exchange rate which is determined by market forces. It is determined by market forces means it is the flexible. But central bank or RBI intervenes. Central bank jo hai India ka, that intervenes in the foreign exchange market to keep the foreign exchange rate within the desired limit. Within the desired limits, how it is? By selling and purchasing. By selling and buying. In the foreign exchange for the Indian economy. So therefore, central bank on the behalf of the government, that is the RBI in India, that interfere, that will enter in the foreign exchange market and keep the control to keep this foreign exchange rate, which is very much floating daily, to keep it within the desired limit. And how it can keep it within the desired limit? By selling and purchasing foreign exchange in the foreign exchange market. Therefore, it is called as the mixing of both. It is flexible because it is determined by the market forces, plus it is also the fixed exchange, fixed system, because government interferes, because the central bank intervenes. Central bank keep the limits on the exchange rate. Therefore, we can say it is the combination of this third is the combination of flexible as well as the fixed exchange rate system, because the interference of the central bank in this system, it is also called as the dirty floating system of exchange rate. Now come to the operation, how the central bank intervenes to keep this foreign exchange rate within the limit. We are explaining the same. Okay, come to this. The interference of the government or the central bank. First, we can say case number one. In the first case, when the foreign exchange rate is too much high, this is the situation.
When foreign exchange rate is too much high, then central bank will sell
exchange, supply increases and automatically for the exchange rate will come down. Now we are going to the second case, case 2. What will happen in this situation? K. For example, we can say K foreign exchange rate is too much low. It is too much low than the desired limit. Agar central bank chahta hai ki lowest uska 55 rate hona chahiye, 55 rupees $1, aur wo 55 rupees se niche ja raha hai, to wo bhi unfavorable hai. ठीक है, क्यों? क्योंकि हमारे एक्सपोर्ट्स लेवल नॉट बाय बाय द फॉरनर्स. इन दिस सिचुएशन अवर फॉर एक्सपोर्ट अर्निंग विल कम डाउन. ओके, देयरफॉर अगेन द सेंट्रल बैंक विल इंटरवीन एंड सेंट्रल बैंक क्या चाहता है? इंक्रीज इन फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रेट. इंक्रीज इन फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रेट मतलब डॉलर की प्राइस जो है वो बढ़ाना चाहता है. इंक्रीज इन द प्राइस ऑफ डॉलर. अब वो क्या करेगा? विल बाय डॉलर इन द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मार्केट. जैसे ही उसने परचेज किया, अदर फैक्टर्स रिमेन कांस्टेंट. ठीक है, सप्लाई ऑफ डॉलर्स विल कम डाउन इन द मार्केट. शॉर्टेज ऑफ डॉलर्स होते वेन द सप्लाई विल कम डाउन, फॉरेन एक्सचेंज it will again be reasonable. So whatever the target of the central bank to increase the foreign exchange, that has been achieved, again it will come to the market. So this is the system by which the foreign exchange rate that is kept within the desired limit by the central bank through the selling and purchasing of foreign exchange. And this system is called as the managed floating exchange rate. Means floating exchange rate which is going on fluctuation, it is to be managed by the central bank through the sale and purchase of foreign exchange. Okay, so after this now we will do the another concept that is related to the appreciation and depreciation in the next lecture. Okay, beta, goodbye to all of you.